Welcome to the John F. Kennedy Space Center, which since 1950, has been NASA's main U.S. launch site for space flights and long-range missiles. It extends 34 miles from north to south and is 10 miles at its widest point, spanning the Banana River and covering a large portion of Merritt Island. Nearby to the south is Patrick Air Force Base. In 2010, SpaceX became the first company to launch a privately built spacecraft into orbit and return it safely to Earth. The company was founded in 2002 by Elon Musk. On March 30, 2017, SpaceX became the first entity to successfully launch and fly a reusable orbital-class rocket. SpaceX isn't only making big spacecrafts in its pursuit of creating a community on Mars. The company is also partnering with NASA to make specialized spacesuits. In 2017, SpaceX became a part of a long tradition when its Falcon 9 rocket took off from Launch Complex 39A at the Kennedy Space Center, where the Apollo 11 moon mission began. It was also the first entity to use it since the complex was retired in 2011. The Dragon spacecraft is named after the song, Puff the Magic Dragon. The Falcon 9 and Falcon Heavy rockets are named after, you guessed it, the Millennium Falcon from Star Wars. If it's good enough for Han Solo. Kennedy Space Center has been the launch site for every U.S. manned space flight since 1968. The center is interesting for visitors of any age. You'll get a tour of the functioning launch equipment and spacecraft, you can hold rocks from the moon, talk and even dine with real astronauts, and get the full pilot's experience when you strap into the Apollo launch simulator.
United 1777, 10 via the Ola 1 arrival, except maintained by level 240.
Clear to descend via the Ola 1, except flight level 240, United 1777.
One of its most notable and iconic attractions is the Vehicle Assembly Building, which is the fourth largest structure in the world by volume. The building is home to the largest American flag, a 209 feet tall, 110 foot wide star-spangled banner painted on the side of the Vehicle Assembly Building. The Vehicle Assembly Building was constructed for the assembly of the Apollo and Saturn V moon rocket, the largest rocket made by humans at the time. For 30 years, its facilities were used during the Space Shuttle program and are now available to commercial partners as part in support of a multi-user spaceport. Launch Complex 39 consists of three launch subcomplexes. Vehicles launched: Saturn V Apollo, Saturn V Skylab, Space Shuttle Columbia, Space Shuttle Challenger, Space Shuttle Discovery, Space Shuttle Atlantis, Space Shuttle Endeavour, Falcon 9, Falcon Heavy. Launch Complex 39 was renovated for the Space Shuttle program, with most of the modifications located at Launch Pads 39A and 39B. A fixed service structure was built on both launch pads, which wrapped around the Space Shuttle during launch preparations and rolled back on hinges as the launch neared.
Jet speed 255, turn 10 degrees right, descend and maintain 5,000, altimeter 2996.
10 degrees right, down 5,000, jet speed 255, do you need a specific range or just normal?
A normal rate for now, I'll let you know if I need something else.
Sure.
At the end of our little excursion, we land on one of the historically most famous runways in the world. The shuttle landing facility was used by Space Shuttle for landing until July 2011. It was also used for takeoffs and landings for NASA training jets such as the Shuttle Carrier Aircraft and for civilian aircraft. Starting in 2015, Space Florida manages and operates the facility under a 30-year lease from NASA. Private companies have been utilizing the runway now. The shuttle landing facility covers 2 million square meters and has a single runway. It is one of the longest runways in the world, at 15,000 feet long, and is 300 feet wide. The runway surface consists of an extremely high-friction concrete strip designed to maximize the braking ability of the space shuttle at its high landing speed, with a paving thickness of 16.0 inches at the center. Thanks for watching this little movie. If you enjoyed this little excursion, I would be happy to get a thumbs up. I'm looking forward to the next trip.